with Laurent Yung, founder of the Sommailier Wine Club. And a little bit about your background. You have deep roots in the French wine industry, and you spent much of your early life on your father's vineyard. Now, after a brief hiatus, you're returning to your roots, and you're bringing the boutique French wines to the U.S. Right. So did I leave anything out? Would you like to expand on that?
Yeah, well, that, in a nutshell, I think that's exactly what happened. Yeah, I moved to San Diego about 4.5 years ago with my wife and 3 kids. And like you said, I think my, the first 20 years of my life were spent on my dad's vineyard. And yeah, I mean, my whole family was in the wine making business for 5 generations. So I always had that in my veins and in my blood. So that, I think it just made sense at some point in my life to go back to my roots. And that's what I'm doing with Sommailier.
And I think that was a wonderful decision because you bring so much joy to people. There's nothing more beautiful than being with family or friends and having a delicious glass of wine to accompany the occasion, any occasion. And so you are doing a wonderful service to the world.
Thank you. Now,
well, there's nothing like a good meal or good friends and a wonderful glass of wine. And there's nothing worse than taking a sip and saying, oh my, I don't like this. This doesn't go. You know, so I compliment you on your decision. Now, your wine subscription is unique in that it focuses on the boutique wines from around the world. And now, if you can tell everyone, what sets Sommailier apart from other subscriptions?
Yeah, so Catherine, so the one thing is actually it's not around the world. It's only French. So it's 100% French wine.
Oh, it's all French. Okay. I'm sorry.
No, that's okay, but I think that's really what sets me aside from other wine clubs today, because I think a lot of wine clubs, they are trying to sell pretty much everything to everyone, and you know, I don't feel comfortable with that. For me, my family and I, we know a lot about French wines. We embraced it since we are kids, and I think we just want to tell the story about what we know, and we don't want to tell the story of someone who told the story of someone who told the story.
So,
that makes sense. I think that was really important, you know, for me. I almost, at the beginning when I started Sommailier, I even thought about maybe doing it just from, you know, one from Bordeaux, because I'm from the region of Bordeaux.
Yes.
But since we have connections in other places in France and, through the company, my brother has a wine distribution company. And
yes.
he's been looking and finding boutique wines from all of our friends for many, many years. So the whole idea was really to leverage this and to bring it to the U.S. I'm in the U.S., so it's an easy bridge. You know, you have my brother and my family over there. I'm here. It's a lot easier for me to do it than probably anyone else, I think, through the many connections we have. So.
Excuse me. What made you decide to begin it in California, to debut it in California?
Well, that was easy for me because I live in San Diego right now. And so the Californian market is a big market for direct-to-consumer wine consumption. And the whole idea, you have to start with something somewhere. I think it made sense for me to start with California and to expand to other states, sooner than later. But like when you start a business, you want to have a proof of concept. You want to make sure that people think like me when I had the idea, like you, you say very nice things about my decision to start Sommailier. But, you know, for every business, you want a proof of concept. You want to make sure that this is what people are looking for. So focusing on California, I think, makes sense at the beginning.
I understand. But when you do what you love, I think you do it well. And obviously, I'm sure you love what you do, and you're bringing that to other people, and they can tell. And now, I'm in New York. Yes. Here on Long Island, and can people from other states and order, and do you ship to other states at this point?
Not yet. We're in the process of getting the appropriate licenses to be able to ship to other states. But at the moment, we only ship in California.
I see, but that's coming on the road.
Yeah, we're really hoping like within 2 or 3 months we'll have we'll be able to ship to other states.
Wonderful. Now, when you order the wine, if you find a particular wine that you like in what you send, can you reorder that wine, or is each box unique?
Yeah, no, absolutely. You can reorder the wine. So every wine that I bring from France, I mean, I make sure that I have enough wine for the members to discover, and then I have enough wine to stock for the members who will like the wine, so they can reorder this wine. And you know, I mean, in the future, I want to make sure that the members have something to say as well. Like, so when they try a wine and they like the wine, so they I want them to tell me, so I can actually bring more of those wines to the US. So it's gonna evolve. I want to make sure that the members are really members and not just random customers. So they have a say to improve the club as well.
Well, I'm sure when someone likes it, they will come back for more. Now, can you send Sommailier as a gift? Because I know I have many wine lovers in my family, and if you want to send it as a birthday or anniversary or just because, you can send them as gift boxes as well, right?
Yeah, you can, and it's very interesting. I mean, really, when I started the Sommailier, my main mission was to get members and really to educate them and have them stay with me so you can really teach them a little bit what you know. I mean, I want to transfer the knowledge of my family to the members. But I also have these gifts offered. And what's interesting is that a lot of the members, so first of all, they become a member. They like the wine. They like the packaging. And they start sending that to their friends. And actually the gift recipient, so the friend now becomes a member because he likes it, and then he also likes the gift ID, so he sent that to another friend. So it's very interesting what's happening. Because again, I mean, those are unique wines. They cannot be found anywhere else in the US. And they have a story. I mean, I think with Living the Gourmet, I read through what you do, and I think you are very keen on making sure that there is a story. When you talk about the kitchen, like you say, it's not a place. It's more than a place. It's where so many things happen.
And well,
I've been able to connect with that because that just reminded me a lot of the discussions we had with my dad about the wine he was making. So drinking wine was more than just drinking wine. There was like all the stories about the wine So anyway, that's to go back to the gift. Yeah, we do gifts, and I think so far people are really enjoying receiving them and giving them.
Well, thank you, because I do feel that the kitchen is the heart, and myself growing up, my dad was a butcher, and by trade, and food was the key and the heart of the home, and there were always people coming in and people going out, and holidays were just family and a lot of baking and a lot of cooking and a lot of noise. And I think you can relate to that as a Frenchman, because people love to sing, they love to have a glass of wine, a piece of cheese, they eat dinner, and a few hours later, they start over again with the nuts and the fruit and the... So, kitchen is home, it is the home.
Yeah, and being French, we spend a lot of time in the kitchen, that's right.
Oh, yes. The food, and the French food, and very similar, the specific desserts for the holidays, and the wines to go with the meals. you know, you can't ever forget that, and that gives you a feeling of you want to give the same thing to your children to have those memories. No one can ever replace that.
Yeah, absolutely. But my
own experience with your wine has been excellent, and from the packaging to the presentation of the wines, and they are delicious. But I don't want to give too much away, because I do plan on giving a beautiful review of your put it on. I wanted to put that on with our interview, so that's coming in the next few days. And but it is definitely something to recommend, and I really am looking forward for when you can expand to the New York, the Northeast area, New York, and around the country, because I know people will enjoy this and want more.
Well, thank you. Thank you. I think that's the best, you know, the best testimonial I can get is really from people like you who experience the receiving of the packaging, who experience the tasting of the wine. You've seen, and again, you're right, you don't want to give too much away, because I can talk too much, and then I'll tell all the secrets. So I want people to discover, you know, for themselves as well. But I think so far all the members have been very happy with them.
I think that it's beautiful. It's delicious, and as I said, it's when you take a first sip, that's very important. When the first sip, you know, brings a smile, and your eyes go open wide, and you think, that's important. It's just like when I'm cooking, and my son comes in the kitchen, and I say, "Taste this." I know immediately when I see his eyebrows go up and his face. I know it's good.
Exactly.
So I feel the same way. And now, is there a website that you'd like to say for people to go visit?
Yeah, absolutely. So my website is Sommailier, Sommailier. .com. So obviously we played with the name because, you know, it's like a real sommelier. You know, is the one who the person who will recommend, you know, what wine will go well with what food. So we really played with that name, but we instead of writing the word sommelier, we put sommelier, because we're going to ship the wine directly to your home. So we're going to mail the wine to you.
Yes.
So that was
and also, there's nothing better than getting a package in the mail, right? I mean, you enjoy getting that. It's like, oh my God, it's here! I can't wait. Here, so that's also a fun experience. And I want to thank you, Laurent, for visiting. And I would love for you to come back again. And when you expand and more states in a few months, I think that would be wonderful to visit again. And we can redo the whole thing. Have you back again? That would be fun.
That'd be fun. I'll do it anytime. Yeah.
If you're ever in New York, if you ever come to Long Island, if you're ever in this area, I would love for you to visit and meet the people that I speak with. That would be wonderful. You and your family.
Well, that's very nice. Thank you, Captain. Thank you.
Thank you, and have a very happy and blessed Thanksgiving.
You too.
Thank you. Thank you for listening. Bye-bye.